和中共济携手前行多元文化融合及反种族歧视论坛与演出活动，2024年10月12日在万锦市政厅举办。
我们今天的和中共济携手前行多元文化融合及反种族歧视的论坛和演出，我是主持人杨毅，非常荣幸今天能够参加这样一个特别有意义的活动。
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the forum and performance of Multicultural Integration and Unite Against Racism and Discrimination. I'm today's MC, Elizabeth Brown. 我是今天的主持人顾晓玲。
大家下午好，我是今天的主持人陈晨，非常荣幸能够参加今天的活动。
大家都知道呢，现在的世界呢，用一句话来讲呢，可以说是有一点不太平。那么在乌克兰和俄罗斯冲突不断，在中东地区也是战火纷飞。那么来到我们加拿大的国内呢，也同样面临着很多的问题。可以看到有移民的问题，有特别我们今天特别关注的种族歧视的问题，有族群撕裂的问题，有生活压力的问题，等等等等，不一而足。
In today's globalized era, the integration of diverse cultures not only enriches our society, but also brings intimate possibilities and opportunities to our lives. However, we also face many challenges. For example, in Far East...
此次活动由家中企业家联合会主办，33个社团或企业联办和协办，旨在倡导多元文化的融合与反对种族歧视，共同推进一个更加包容和和谐的社会。
面对这些困境和挑战，我们有没有办法呢？答案是肯定的。第一个原因叫和中共济。和中共济的意思呢，就是我们今天讲的多元文化的融合，不同的文化完全可以和而不同，美美与共。另外一个解决办法呢，就是携手前行，那就和我们今天的反种族的反种族歧视的这样的一个主题呢息息相关。因为大家无论是什么样的种族，无论是什么样子文化，大家可以合作共赢，携手前行，多元文化融合和反种族歧视。
To have world peace, we have to support multicultural integration and unite against racism and discrimination.
我们今天的活动呢是可以说安排的非常的丰富多彩，它的内容是主要包括了有主题演讲，就是针对我们刚才讲到和中共济的内容和携手前行的部分，也有圆桌会议，针对多元文化融合和反种族歧视进行一些讨论。那么还有精彩的演出，当然还有为我们做出特别贡献的个人和团体颁发一些表彰和奖励。接下来将进入我们今天的主题演讲的部分。那么首先让我们有请家中企业家联合会的会长刘慧云女士代表主办方致欢迎词，同时呢也要做举办这个和中共济携手同行活动的主题分享，掌声有请。
Good afternoon, Honorary Chair of the Organizing Committee, Honorable MP Paul Chen. Good afternoon, everyone.On behalf of Canada-China Federation of Entrepreneurs, on behalf of the organizing committee of this event, I would like to say thanks to dear all coming to join and support the event. 各位新老朋友，大家好。感谢你们每个人都以不同的方式在支持和中共济携手前行的活动。Especially, I want to appreciate Canada government's trust, support and funding. 特别感谢加拿大政府的信任、支持和资助，得以合中共济、携手前行活动今天能够举行。也要感谢到会支持和或者是发来贺信的13位政要，还要感谢没能到会发来贺信的3位华侨侨领，更要感谢共同主办、联办、协办的33个社团或者是企业，还要感谢8个媒体的大力支持，同时也要感谢专家学者、律师、警察、论坛嘉宾、主持人，还有导演、原创作者以及演员，还有义工，都在以各自的专业服务做着合中共济、携手前行现在进行时的事情。加拿大是第一个国家把多元文化写入宪法，多元文化的五彩斑斓和多元一体是每个加拿大人的自豪，但是我们任何人，特别企业和社团，在多元一体的融合中，遇到种族歧视的时候，我们应该团结起来，反对任何形式的种族歧视，合中共济，携手前行，捍卫企业、社团、个人的合法权益。我这里是算抛砖引玉，期待各位嘉宾的精彩演讲。再次感谢大家齐心协力，合中共济，携手前行。预祝今天的多元文化融合及反种族歧视论坛和演出圆满成功，谢谢大家。
好，谢谢我们的主席刘桂云女士。那么接下来呢，我们有请我们的国会议员蒋振宇先生来做今天合中共济，携手前行的主题核心发言。
Please warmly welcome MP Bo Chang, Honorary Chair of the event, to deliver the keynote speech on multiculturalism and anti-racism.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for inviting me here today. I'm happy to be here to speak on behalf of our federal government about racism and discrimination and multiculturalism. As the MC has introduced me as the Member of Parliament for Markham Unionville, which is where we are right now in my riding, and I'm also the Parliamentary Secretary for Immigration, Refugee and Citizenship. I extend my warmest greetings to the Canada-China Friendship Federation of Entrepreneurs for hosting this great event. Besides promoting economic and trade cooperation in Canada and in China, CCFOE has always demonstrated a commitment to addressing systemic racism and discrimination, both within the organization and in the community. I applaud the effort and I truly appreciate all the great work that has been done to addressing these challenges. I would also like to take a moment to thank Gina Liu, the president of CCFOE, for this great initiative. These efforts should be mirrored by all community organizations as racism and discrimination affect so many of us on a daily basis. As a retired police officer, where I worked the last 15 years in the hate crime unit, I have seen firsthand the hate that exists in our society. I have listened to stories of individuals who have been denied opportunities simply because of the color of the skin or the cultural background. These stories are not just statistics, they are the lived experience of our neighbors, friends, and family members. That is why I work so hard to make the police service a safer and more inclusive space for all of us, especially for women and people of color. I also want to bring up my life in Canada. I've been now in Canada for 47 years of my life. I've been married for 43 years of my life. I have one son and two daughters. And the reason I bring that up is, in policing, you see a lot of domestic violence. And the victim mostly in domestic violence are women, right? And I wanted to raise my daughters so that they are strong individuals, so they can take care of themselves as an adult when they get married. So all my children are married. My son is married with three kids. My older daughter is married with three kids. And my younger daughter is also married with no children. So as you know, I have six grandchildren. My oldest granddaughter is 15 years old, and she's in grade 10 high school. So I am an old man. My son is 42, so there you go. So he's not a young one. He's also in his 40s now. Now on the flip side, so it is important to me that we all are well represented in society, in Canadian society, right? It's very important for us to be in every sector of this country. Like, doesn't matter in private business, in government agency, or in private practice, or in the medical field or legal field. I'm so happy to see all of the initiatives in our communities that are combating all of that negativity, right? As a member of parliament, I have the honor and pleasure of working on the Canada's first national action plan to combat hate crime. Canada's first ever action plan on combating hate crime will fund 20 initiatives that will prevent hate crime, provide support for victims and survivors, and build trust between the communities that experience hate and agency who respond to incidents of hate. Our government has also invested $273 million to combat hate crime. So agencies have an opportunity to get some of those funding so that they can better prepare themselves for any hate that comes through to them. As a proud immigrant and a person of color myself, it was so important for me that people from all walks of life feel safe in Canada. I want all of you to remember that in a world often defined by headlines and international news, it is easy to lose sight of the personal connection and the good people around us that truly drive meaningful change. We must all commit to examining our own biases, to have difficult conversation, and to dismantle the systems that create inequality. This is not a task for the government alone. It is a collective responsibility of all of us. We must work together, communities, organizations, and individuals, to create an environment where diversity is celebrated and inclusion is the norm. Today, I urge each of you to reflect on own beliefs and actions. Challenge the stereotypes, stand up against injustice, and be an ally to those who cannot stand up for themselves. It is our duty to create a society where everyone feels valued, where differences are embraced, and where we can all succeed together. Like I said, I have been married for 43 years, and I live right here in Markham Unionville, and all my children live here in Markham Unionville, and we have been living in the city of Markham for the past 35 years. This is a great place for us to live, work, and grow our family. And on top of that, I wanted to point out that in York region, there is no drug or safe injection site anywhere in York region. So you need to be aware of that. In the city of Markham and the city of Richmond Hill, there are no marijuana shops anywhere. This is a great work of the city themselves to make sure that we keep our community safe. So it's important for you to know that we do live in a great region, a great city, and a great country. Right? So we should all embrace what we have, and we should move forward to make our country an even better place. I know most of you are from China here in the room. Some of us are not from China. And most of you have met me already, but I just wanted to add, I was born in Pakistan, Karachi, Pakistan. 我祖籍是从湖北来的，我爷爷1927年从湖北出来了，所以那个时候是印度，现在是巴基斯坦，我父亲父母也是在那边出生的。 我跟我弟弟、哥哥们都是在那边出生的。我太太也是华人，她也是巴基斯坦出生的。我太太是客家人，我是湖北人，就是希望大家都合作，所以聚乐快乐，谢谢。 Thank you so much, everyone. I also have a certificate for
非常感谢我们的国会议员蒋振宇先生专程带来了贺信，我们有请刘慧云会长来接受来自我们国会议员蒋振宇先生的贺信。大家下午好，非常高兴有机会跟大家分享，谢谢魏长刘慧长，你一直以来就会抓住这个贸易做了很多的贡献，还有我们的盘博士。 做了很多，尤其对他家乡长沙对吧？做了很多好事。Thank you very much for inviting me, and I'm so privileged to follow Parliamentary Assistant Mr. Paul Zhang, who's the Member of Parliament here, to share something with you.
列治文山市副市长陈志辉回顾了他18年前开始参选，并获选为列治文山市的首位少数族裔市议员，深感责任深重，一路走来非常艰辛，但为了让主流社会听到少数族裔的声音，兢兢业业为民众服务，终获市民的认可。2022年，并当选列治文山市副市长。Thank
you very much. Good afternoon, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, thank you so much for your coming out. And my name is Alan Ho, and I'm so happy to see so many people are here today. And today we gather.
陈志辉和胡锦主题发言，分别就多元文化在经济和社会中的重要性发表个人见解。他们探讨了如何通过文化融合促进经济繁荣。The
federal government has recently announced a new anti-racism strategy. Our government is steadfast in our commitment to fight racism at every turn, and that starts with concrete action. Diversity Minister Kira just announced the launch of Changing Systems, Transforming Lives, Canada's Anti-Racism Strategy 2024 to 2028. This new strategy builds upon the first iteration and is informed by substantial community input.
Why would I mention about these two films? The short film, which is a documentary, is about the Exclusion Act, which is the Chinese head tax. We had it about like 100 years ago. But this
万锦市议员杨启清声情并茂地讲述了多元文化核心价值的意义。
Have we really passed that? We received an apology. We received an acknowledgement that it was a wrong.
Regarding the racism and hate crime, So this is a big topic, 所以我就说，多伦多是一个非常的多元文化的一个城市。我们纳豆地区，我们的人口组合，不同的人种、不同的族裔、不同的肤色，从世界各地来到这里，世界上每一个地方发生任何事情都会影响到我，包括现在的中东的战争。 在这些情况下，当然我们怀疑。 So I'm talking about the racism
against Asian. 那么我们 this would be 亚裔，特别是华裔，受到了种族歧视和那个仇恨的犯罪上升了47%在加拿大。所以我们很多人在座的可能都有很多人已经感受到或者经历过这个对我们种族的一种歧视，或者是一种不公平的对待。
胡一警官详细介绍了警察如何应对种族歧视和仇恨犯罪，进一步提高了公众对法律和执法的理解。此次活动得到了加拿大三级政要贺信与多方支持，他们是国会议员马万里 MP Majid Johari、 陈胜元 MP Sean Chen、 利亚泰勒 MP Leah Taylor Roy 以及万锦市市长薛家平 Frank Scarpitti、 列治文山市市长魏斯特 David West、 释迦堡市议员万里高 Nick Mantis、 列治文山市市议员崔冰辉 Simon Cui 等人。他们分别高度赞扬加中企业家联合会在推动加中经贸和文化交流、促进多元文化发展和反对种族歧视方面的贡献。华人社区和中共济携手前行联办主席、加拿大福建社团联合总会主席林庆清贺信说，感谢邀请参与，并非常欣赏贵会在推动加中企业合作与发展方面的努力。协办方多伦多社区文化中心行政总监钟新生先生贺信说，加中企业家联合会成立以来，就是加拿大和中国友好交往与经贸合作深化的标志，也是两国经济科技文化交流合作的重要平台，凝心聚力携手共建的桥梁。我们相信贵会会秉承一贯优良传统，凝聚华裔移民力量，反对各种形式的种族歧视，维护合法权利，团结华人社区，加强友好往来，促进经济繁荣，更好地贡献自己的力量。财富人生 CEO 罗良志先生发来贺信，表达和中共济携手前行意愿，向加中企业家联合会和所有联办、协办、支持单位致敬，深知多元文化是社会的动力，而反对种族歧视是每个人的共同责任。非常荣幸能收到邀请并支持这一伟大事业。在职场种族歧视话题上，蒋红律师发表了关于雇主应如何处理工作场所中的种族歧视和骚扰的发言。纪念加拿大铁路华工基金会主席吴玉美 Landy Anderson 主题发言。
And my indigenous spirit name is Boshwan Adewahigan, and that means that I bring the drum or I bring balance.
吴玉美分享了华人在加拿大早期经历歧视的历史，并讲述了如何通过努力争取应有权利的过程，引发了在场嘉宾的深思。
铁路化工吧，这个是我对这个印象比较深。就2011年的时候，我们加拿大纪念那个铁路化工150周年。我当时写了一首长诗，我一个感觉的就是说是非常的感动，就是说加拿大华人就是加拿大重要的一部，我们就是加拿大的主人，没错，我们是客人。再一个就是说是这个我们在这个其中的这个作用非常的重大，没有华人卑斯省就跨到美国去了，所以华人创造了一个加西地区。
我相信今天到会场所有的伙伴的话呢，都是非常关注反种族歧视的伙伴，我特别感谢你们，因为我曾经也是种族歧视的受害者。因为我经常在国外飘着，然后的话呢，会遇到各种各样的有色人种，他们对华人的话呢，其实是印象有的是不太好的，是非常友好的。那么我对于这个观点的话呢，我非常的赞同刚才这位律师说的，我们华人第一要团结，第二的话呢，勇敢地拿起武器来，无论是法律武器还是身边的武器，来保卫我们自身的权利。
我觉得华人呢，确实我们那位律师提到的铁路，加拿大的铁路，我们华人的历史，很早的话就来到加拿大。我最近去了巴拿马运河的建造，也是离不开我们华人的功劳。也有很多华人留在了巴拿马，因为运河建完以后，虽然我们要尊重这个历史，另外一个呢，我们华人应该要享受我们这个法律的武器，要争取我们自己的权利，因为我们这100多年的那个历史啊，我们华人争取自己权利这个力量呢，我觉得做的是不够的，跟别的族裔比的话，我们要在这方面应该加强。
我们坚决反对种族主义， 加拿大呢，立国的重要原则就是多元文化，它由此集中了全世界的优秀人才，汇集了各民族的精英大师，从而建立了一个公认的美丽国土。这多元文化呢，是各民族各族各色人种组成，所以呢，这各种族裔的人民的和睦相处、融洽和谐，是加拿大国家稳定的基础，也是国家繁荣的关键。所以呢，我们强烈希望加拿大的各级政府要制定出强有力的反种族歧视的有效措施，绝不可姑息任何一件歧视事件的发生。
但是在加拿大，我觉得就是说的种族歧视啊，我觉得在全球啊，加拿大应该是恐怕是最好的。我们也看到这一点，我们来到这个国家，我们也感恩这一点。不要过，一个方面有问题要提醒，但是还我觉得更多的人要感恩，因为在世界上像加拿大这么这样的社会啊，其实很少。但是当然，现在有99%的好，我们还需要把它那个往那个100%的那种美好迈进。
本次和中共济携手前行多元文化论坛与演出，不仅展示了加拿大多元文化的魅力，也在社会各界中再次呼吁大家共同努力，反对种族歧视。 推进包容与和谐社会的建设。在活动的最后，主办方由家中企业家联合会会长刘慧云和和中共济携手前行活动联办主席约克区议员和胡景，为在促进多元文化与反对种族歧视方面做出突出贡献的个人和团体颁发了社区杰出贡献奖、社区贡献奖感谢状。
中每个民族找到了自己的位置，没有仇恨能让我们的光芒暗淡，因为我们共同反对偏见的阴影，手牵手我们并肩前行，在和平的土地上永远多元文化是我们的力量，反对种族歧视，我们的声音坚定，因为在加拿大我们都是亲人，在多样性中每颗心都愿意真诚。